हेलो, माई सेल्फ मीता प्रजापति, लेक्चरर इन कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग, गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक, गांधीनगर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाइब्रिड इनहेरिटेंस एंड वर्चुअल बेस क्लास। सो लर्निंग आउटकम्स ऑफ दिस टॉपिक इज, आफ्टर लर्निंग दिस टॉपिक स्टूडेंट विल बी एबल टू डेवलप प्रोग्राम्स using hybrid inheritance and develop programs using virtual base class. According to the syllabus, topics to be covered 4.7 hybrid inheritance, 4.8 virtual base class. Now let us understand hybrid inheritance. Hybrid inheritance is a combination of multiple inheritance and multi-level inheritance that we have discussed and learned in last lecture. So class is derived from two classes, as in multiple inheritance. However, one of the parent classes is not a base class, it is a derived class. So here the graphical representation of the hybrid inheritance shown. So there are two derived class, derived class 1 and derived class 2, having one base class, and derived class 3 has a combination of derived class 1 and 2. So hybrid inheritance is a combination of multiple inheritance and multi-level inheritance. A skeleton of hybrid inheritance: class A is a base class, class B is a derived class, class C is a derived class, and class D having a two derived class, public B and public C. So this is the simple skeleton to understand the hybrid inheritance. Let us understand through the example hybrid inheritance. Class student having the protected member int is a roll number, and there are two member function, get number, put number. So we are reading the get number, means we are going to read the roll number and will display the roll number. Again class test. Now public student is a base class, class test is a derived class, having the two protected members, subject 1 and subject 2, having the member function get marks and put marks. So here we will get the marks of two subject and will display the marks of subject 1 and subject 2. Now class result is a derived class, and public test is a base class, having the private member function float total and public member function display. And in display function we are adding the marks of two subject total. Finally we will put the number, marks and total of the student. So here the main part, in main function we are creating the object of r1, result r1 dot get number, we are passing the 101 and marks of two subject 80 and 90, and finally it will display the r1 dot display. So this is the example of hybrid inheritance. Okay, class student is a base class. Okay, and class test is a derived class. Even class result is a derived class. Finally, the result has a combination of test class and student class. So this is called the hybrid inheritance. Now let us understand the next topic, 4.8 virtual base class. Now say, in graphical representation, grandparent is a base class, parent 1, parent 2 derived class, and in child class C, having the parent 1, parent 2 is a base class and child class is a derived class. So the child class has two direct base class, parent 1 and parent 2, which themselves have a common base class, grandparent. So the child class inherits all data of grandparent via two separate paths. Okay, so the child has all the properties from the grandparent via two paths, via parent 1 and parent 2. So it can also directly inherit as shown by line. This is the skeleton of virtual base class. Class grandparent is a base class, class parent 1 is a derived class, class parent 2 is a derived class. Now virtual public grandparent, virtual public grandparent. So here we are having the two base class, class parent 1 and class parent 2, having the common public grandparent base class. Class child has all the properties of public 1 parent 1 and public parent 2 via the grandparent. So here this is the example, class grandparent. Here I have declared the integer I. Now class parent 1 is a base class, virtual public grandparent integer j. Class parent 2, virtual public grandparent integer k. Now class child is a derived class having the public parent 1 and public parent 2. And finally we are displaying the sum. So this is the main part, void main, child c1. So here whenever we write c1 dot I is equal to 10, only one copy of I is inherited. Actually they are having a two path, parent 1 and parent 2, but here only one copy is shared. So this is the main use of the virtual base class. Whenever we declare virtual, it will share only the single copy of the that class, okay, to avoid the ambiguities. C1 dot j is equal to 20, C1 dot k is equal to 30. Finally C1 dot sum is equal to C1 dot I plus C1 dot j plus C1 dot k, and finally it will display the 60 sum. Okay, so to avoid the ambiguities we have to declare as a virtual. So this is called the virtual base class. So finally the conclusion is, the inheritance in which the derivation of a class involves more than one form of any inheritance is called the C++ hybrid inheritance. In short, hybrid inheritance is the process of deriving a class using more than one level or more than one mode of inheritance. The virtual base class is used whenever derived class has multiple copies of the base class. Okay, if there are more than one copy of base class, we have to declare as a virtual. So a child class could have duplicate set of members inherited from a single base class. So C++ solves this issue by introducing a virtual base class. Okay, these are the books and references you can refer. Thank you.